My name's Sam Young.
And I'm Cole McKinney.
And we did our presentation on the Triple Crown.
A little background on the Triple Crown. It's the greatest accomplishment for thoroughbred racing. It consists of three races of three-year-old thoroughbred horses. The three races consist of the Kentucky Derby, the Preakness Stakes, and the Belmont Stakes.
While we were researching, we found a little-known fact, and it was the Triple Tiara. So this is kind of like the Philly version of the Triple Crown. It also consists of three races at the same three sites. That's the Kentucky Oaks, the Black Eyed Susan Stakes, and the Acorn Stakes. And a little fun fact too is there's only been one Triple Tiara winner ever, and that was Devona Dale. A lot don't even try it because for fillies, the turnaround time, it's a little too short and they can risk a lot of injury.
Belmont Stakes is actually hosted in Belmont Park in Elmont, New York. Its nicknames are the Test of the Champion and the Run for Carnations. This race is held 5 weeks after the Derby and 3 weeks after the Preakness. The distance of this race is approximately 1.5 miles, and currently the purse is around $1.5 million.
So a little background on Belmont Park too. It's actually located on Long Island, just outside New York City. It opened in 1905, and has a total capacity of about 100,000 people. The only venue of the Triple Crown that doesn't allow people to picnic in the infield, like they do at Churchill and Pimlico. It's open for spring and fall meets.
This park was named after August Belmont Jr., a financier and sportsman. His nickname was Big Sandy due to prominent overall dimensions and sometimes tiring surfaces. The park's operated by a nonprofit organization called New York Racing Association.
So there's a lot of traditions at all three of these races, so we're going to kind of highlight them throughout the presentation. So for instance, for Belmont, the official flower is the white carnation, which symbolizes love and luck. It takes 700 carnations to make the 40-pound blanket that they drape over the winner of the race each year. Also in 1997, the official drink used to be the white carnation, and now it's the Belmont Breeze. The New York Times gave it terrible reviews for both of the cocktails and actually called them refined trash can punch. And the post-parade song is New York, New York by Frank Sinatra.
The Preakness Stakes is hosted by or at the Pimlico Race Course in Baltimore, Maryland. Nicknames for this race are Run for the Black-Eyed Susans because of the yellow flowers that are placed around the winner's neck. This race is held 2 weeks after the Derby and 3 weeks before Belmont.
So then the little background on the Pimlico Race Course. It's in Baltimore, Maryland. As we said, it opened in 1870. Has a total capacity of over 120,000 people, so it's a little bigger than a Belmont Park.
Some history. The race course was named after Old Ben Pimlico, a tavern in London. It had a nickname of Old Hilltop after a small rise in the infield. This race course is owned by Maryland Jockey Club, and it actually hosted the Great Race.
We actually stumbled upon this when we were doing research too. We found out about the Great Race. So it was in 1877, and basically Congress shut down for an entire day, so all the congressmen could go out to Pimlico. The race was 2.5 miles long. It was between the three great horses at the time. It consisted of Tim Broke, Tom Ochiltree, and Pearl. About 20,000 attended the event, and it's still talked about a ton today.
Now we're going to talk about the Preakness Stakes. This race is This has a distance of 1 3/16 miles, and the current purse is $1.5 million.
Another thing we found cool about the Preakness Stakes is something they do call the Enfield Fest. So up until 2009, at Pimlico, you could bring your own alcohol in. You could bring in kegs, you could bring in beer, liquor, whatever you wanted. After videos surfaced of intoxicated people running on top of porta potties and getting pelted with beer cans and a lot of other crazy behavior, they changed the rule, so you could not bring in your own alcohol. This caused attendance to drop a ton, about 30,000 each year, which is about a 30% drop, which was huge. So what they decided to do was start something called Infield Fest. This is where there's musical acts, they have the promotionals, similar to a refillable beer mug. So you become part of the mug club, and since they've started Infield Fest, tickets have improved a ton.
The Preakness has a few traditions. One is the flower. The official flower is the Viking palm. Although Black Eyed Susan's is the nickname, they're not actually used because the flower does not bloom actually at that time. One of the cocktails, the official cocktail, is called the Black Eyed Susan, and it's made with vodka, Saint Germain liqueur, and pineapple juice, as well as lime and orange juices. And their post-parade song is Maryland, My Maryland.
Last but not least is definitely the Kentucky Derby. So it's held here in Louisville, Kentucky each year. On May 17th, 1875 was the first running of the Kentucky Derby. Now it's the first Saturday in May every year, no matter what. The race is a mile and a quarter long, and the purse is $2 million, which is well above the other two races.
Now, Churchill Downs is where the Kentucky Derby is held. It's located on Central Avenue in Louisville, Kentucky. Churchill Downs is famous for hosting not only the Derby, but also the Kentucky Oaks. And it can hold around 170,000 people. Horse Players Association of America actually ranked Churchill Downs as one of top five out of 65 thoroughbred racetracks in North America.
A little history of Churchill Downs too. It officially opened in 1875, so around the time of the other tracks. It's Colonel Mayweather Lewis, famous Lewis and Clark, developed the racetrack in order to host a spectacular horse racing event known as the Kentucky Derby. It holds not only the Kentucky Derby and Oaks, but in the past it's had the Breeders' Cup like 8 times, which is big. It moves around the U.S. So the fact that it's been here 8 times is very big for the city and for the race course.
Derby, as many people also know it as the most exciting 2 minutes in sports, also the fastest 2 minutes in sports. And Derby has a nickname called the Run for the Roses because of the large blanket of roses that's placed over the winner.
So like all the other places too, the Kentucky Derby has a ton of traditions. This is just going to be a couple we're going to name off. The official flower is the red roses, obviously. The winner is given 554 of them. That tradition started in 1883. Another fun fact is that the governor is the one who places the red roses on the winner's neck each year. The official cocktail is the mint julep, which is made with bourbon, mint, and sugar syrup. And our post-parade song is My Old Kentucky Home, which is done by the University of Louisville Marching Band each year. The last thing that me and Cole stumbled upon was a pretty cool video about the Triple Crown lineage. We're gonna play that real quick. It basically shows different horses, where they came from, the Triple Crown winners and stuff. It's pretty interesting. So we're gonna play that for you real quick.
Healthcare.gov is open this year for you to sign up for a health plan. It's open November 1st
to December 15th.
Plans cover wellness visits, prescription drugs, and more. Healthcare.gov open enrollment. November 1st to December 15th.
Causes
is in front. I'll have another bearing down on him. And I'll have another get there. Here he comes. Here's the wire. I'll have another get it. Peter Ryan down Bodymeister to win the Preakness. And it's on to Belmont Park, where I'll have another race for the story. Triple Crown.
Okay, so that video just showed a little bit of the lineage of the Triple Crown winners and some of the history. That's all we have for today. I hope you enjoyed our presentation.